Hi guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you are new then welcome to my channel. So in today's video of microscopic series, I'm going to review something which is so overhyped. I've never ever heard a negative review on this product. Now I'm talking about the MAC Strobe Cream. So people use this underneath their foundation to add that extra glow to their matte foundations. They use it mixed in with their foundation. They use it also on top of their foundation as a highlighter. So this is more like a multi-purpose glow giver sort of a product. Now this is a new product to me. I'm going to use this for the first time today. But all of those things that I just mentioned, I do that with my LA Girl Luminous Glow Skin Illuminator. I do all of those. So I use this underneath my foundation. I use it mixed in with my foundation. I use it as an illuminator. I use this for basically everything. So I thought, why not compare these two? So first off, I'm just going to squeeze out a little bit of MAC Strobe Cream. So I've taken out a little bit of MAC Strobe Cream and I'm going to blend it out and see what sort of a glow do you really get out of this. Now, I bought the mini version of it and there were not many shades available in the mini version. So this is the shade that I have. I'm not sure what shade this really is, but it will be mentioned on the screen. So this is how my hand is looking like right now. I don't see any glitter or shimmer as of yet, but again, I'm going to see this under the microscope and really see if this has got any shimmer or glitter particles in it. So far, I don't see any glitter or shimmer. Now, let me show you this product. So this is the LA Girl Luminous Glow Illuminator. I just mentioned that. Now, if you guys have been watching my channel, you would know that I should probably take it out on this hand. I love this product, and with this, a little goes a very long way. So I've taken out very little of this, and this one is in the shade Afterglow, I think. Yes, and oh my god, this shade matches my skin tone so well. So I'm going to now blend this side out. So I featured this product in my video that I did on products I would buy if my makeup disappeared, and this was in that video, so you know how much I love this product. So this is how my hand looks like right now after blending that out. So I'm going to give you a side-by-side comparison. This is the Strobe Cream and this is the LA Girl. I'm not sure if you can really tell a difference. Yeah, I mean both the sides look pretty much the same. Looks very glowy. The LA Girl side though has got very tiny micro specks of shimmer, and you can only see when you're like this close and really paying attention, but otherwise you really cannot tell a difference. I think Coral Lister really swears by it. She recommends this product to everybody who is looking for something of this sort. I think I went a little overboard because it's borderline looking oily, and it's also a little bit sticky. I think that's because I used a little bit too much. I don't face this problem with my LA Girl ones. Now I'm going to go ahead and apply this on the other side of my face. Now with this, I'm going to use this hand because, you know, I blended this illuminator with this hand of mine. So with this, I'm again taking the same amount because, you know, I want to show you guys. Oh, by the way, this is probably going to be too much. Like, I can already tell that. But now, because I've used a lot of this Strobe Cream on this side, I'm going to use equal amount on the LA Girl side as well. Okay, so this is how the LA Girl side looks once blended out. You can see I did use almost the same amount as the Strobe Cream, and this side does not feel oily or sticky to me, but this side does feel very slippery and just, I don't know, very oily. Maybe because I just use a little bit too much. So what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section below which side would you prefer. Once again, this is the Strobe Cream and this is the LA Girl side. Honestly, glow wise, both look pretty same. I think the Strobe Cream is looking a little too much because it's on the oily side a bit, but otherwise both the sides look ultra beaming. So now let's see how MAC Strobe Cream looks like under the microscope. I'm actually very excited to know because honestly, when you just look at it, you can barely see any shimmer. So I want to know, how are you really getting this glow, you know, like how? So let's find that out. I'm just going to wipe it once. Okay, so I guess that's all that I wanted to see. I'm gonna go ahead and put on some makeup and then we'll talk a little bit more about the MAC Stroke Cream. Okay, so I'm back after putting on a full coverage foundation. I used the Maybelline Superstay foundation and honestly, both the sides look really, really pretty. I mean, both the sides have got the glow. The only difference that I can tell is the side with LA Girl has got more of a golden sheen to it, whereas the side with Stroke Cream has got more of a, I wouldn't really call it a pinky sheen, but it's more on the cool tone side. Right now, I really cannot pick one of these, but if you were to ask me to pick one of these right now, especially after putting a full face of foundation, a full coverage foundation, I will still pick the LA Girl side because I honestly just love the golden sheen that it provides you. Yeah, it looks pretty flawless, honestly. I wouldn't say I don't like this side, but I would still pick this one. Now, I'm not going to stop right here. I'm going to use both of these as highlighter and maybe then we'll be able to tell more on the shade of these because, you know, when you put anything on top of your foundation, you can really tell the shade difference. So I'm going to use the Stroke Cream first and I'm just going to dot some of it on the high points of my face, which is basically like a C around this area. I'm not going to put anything on my nose only because I've powdered that area. Some of it goes here on the chin and a little tiny bit on my forehead. Wow, I mean, look at that glow. So pretty, you guys. It's really pretty. Okay, all right, now I'm going to take out the same amount of the LA Girl one. With this, I'm very, very conscious because if you go too much with this, not a good look. Mm-mm. It looks too artificial. So I've taken out about that much. And with this, I'm going to go on the tapered side. And I'm just like directly going to pick this up on my sponge. And again, I'm going to highlight the same area. Okay, so there we go. This is the side with LA Girl and honestly, I'm so confused right now. Both the sides look beautiful. I would say the Stroke Cream side looks more wet because it's more on the oily and tacky side, whereas this looks, it looks glowy. It doesn't look necessarily wet as this one, but it still looks beautiful, especially because of the golden sheen that it has got. So I guess that's all for the comparison. I'm going to talk a bit more on this before we wrap this video up. Alright, so here's my final verdict on the overhyped, over-sensationalized MAC Stroke Cream. Does it live up to the hype, the expectations? I would say yes. It's definitely one of its kind sort of a product. It gives you the glow, but it's not glittery or shimmery. You can really not see the shimmer. 99%, maybe like 1% if you're like really applying too much, maybe then, because I think I did go overboard with this on my forehead and I could see like very fine bits of shimmer. And again, you saw the microscopic footage and that clearly proved all of it. So I would say this is going to be a great option for people who are looking for a glowy sort of illuminator, but it does not have shimmer whatsoever. The only downside that I see with this is if you are on the deeper complexion, like really deep, dark complexion, I wouldn't really recommend the mini version of it because this comes only in one shade and this might look a little stark on your skin tone. So just be a little bit careful of that. But other than that, I really see no harm. You can definitely go ahead and pick up this small size version of it, try it, and definitely invest in the bigger version. I think that's what I'm going to do. I want to try the golden sort of a version of this. So that's it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this mini quick microscopic review and comparison with this product. And that's all for this video. I'll see you in my next one. Bye bye.